Hey, so in today's lesson, you are going to learn 20 advanced business English idioms. Now, I always say that idioms are a great way of boosting your vocabulary and of sounding more natural. It is important to learn idioms in context. So our context today is, of course, business. As well with idioms, make sure that you are using them accurately and correctly. Accuracy is very important when you're using idioms and expressions in English, so just keep that in mind. And now, let's get started. So our first idiom is, my hands are tied. My hands are tied. Now, if you say, my hands are tied, it means, I wish I could help you, I want to help you, but I can't. I am not able to because of some rules or regulations or another person that is stopping me. So I want to help you, but it's impossible. I'm not able to. For example, I wish I could help you, but my hands are tied because it's against company policy to issue a refund without a receipt. Okay, I wish I could help you, but my hands are tied. It's against company policy to issue a refund. So in this example, you are speaking to a customer who wants to return an item, but they don't have a receipt, and maybe they're really nice and you want to help them, but you just can't. Your hands are tied. Idiom number two is to cut corners. Now, if you cut corners, it means that you do a job the fastest, cheapest, easiest way that you possibly can, but the result is usually careless work. There's normally mistakes. You're not paying attention to detail. You're just trying to get the job done as fast as you can and as easily as you possibly can. So, for example, the builder cut corners. They used cheap materials and ended up having to replace them 6 months later. Okay, so the builder cut corners, they used cheap materials, and they ended up having to replace them 6 months later. So again, to cut corners, it's just to work in a fast, lazy way to get a job done as quickly and easily as you can. But usually when you cut corners, you sacrifice quality and you end up having problems later on. Number three is from the ground up, from the ground up. Now, from the ground up means to build something from nothing, to build something from scratch, from zero, from absolutely nothing. And we usually use this idiom when someone starts a company from nothing, from zero. For example, he built this organization from the ground up, and the success of the company is his priority. He built this organization from the ground up, and the success of this company is his priority. So basically, he started the company from nothing, from zero. He didn't buy the company from someone else. He didn't have help. From the ground up. So for number four, we have on track or off track. So we actually have two idioms here. Now, to be on track means to be focused on a specific task. And to be off track basically means the opposite, that you lose focus. Okay, so for example, we don't have much time today. Let's make sure that we stay on track. So you could say this in a meeting, for example. Let's say you don't have a lot of time and you're meeting with your colleagues and there's something important you have to discuss. You could say, we don't have a lot of time, let's try to stay on track, okay? And for off track, you could say, I think we're getting a little off track. So that's a really common way to use it. When you are having a meeting or a discussion and you're kind of getting off topic, you can say, I think we're getting a little bit off track. Number five is bring to the table, to bring something to the table. Now, this means to provide something that will be a benefit for the other person or for the other party. So, for example, she brings 15 years of experience to the table. So, in this example, maybe I am hiring someone to work for my company or to join my team. And I say, she brings 15 years of experience to the table. It means her 15 years of experience will be a benefit to my team or a benefit to my company. Bring something to the table. Number six is to get up to speed, to get up to speed. Now, to get up to speed means to have the latest or most recent information about something. So for example, I want to get up to speed on the latest revisions before the client meeting. I want to get up to speed on the latest revisions before the client meeting. So in this case, maybe we are working on a document or a report or design for a client, and we have revised or changed it, and I want to make sure that I have the most recent version and I understand the most recent changes, the most recent information before we meet the client. Number seven is, it's a long shot. It's a long shot. Now, if you say it's a long shot, it just means it's unlikely to happen. It's probably not going to happen. There's a very slim chance of this thing happening, all right? So for example, I don't think she will be hired for such a senior position. It's a long shot, but there's no harm in applying, okay? I don't think she's gonna be hired. Maybe she is a junior right now. She doesn't have a lot of experience. So the chance of her getting this position is very slim, but she can apply anyway. So it's a long shot. It's probably not gonna happen. Number eight is to pull the plug, to pull the plug on something. So to pull the plug on something means to stop working on something, to discontinue something, or to cancel something. So for example, customer feedback was pretty bad, so they decided to pull the plug on the new cosmetic line. Customer feedback was pretty bad, so the company decided that they are not going to move forward with this line. They're going to cancel it or discontinue it. So to pull the plug, again, means to discontinue or cancel or stop something. Number nine is to stay ahead of the curve, to stay ahead of the curve. Now, to stay ahead of the curve means to maintain an advantage over your competitors. So you already have an advantage and you manage to maintain it or keep it. So for example, they were the first company to introduce Wi-Fi into their cars, so they managed to stay ahead of the curve. They managed to stay ahead of their competitors. Number 10 is to be on the same page or to get on the same page. Now, if you are on the same page as someone, it means that you are in agreement or you share the same opinion about something with someone else, okay? For example, I'm glad that we are all on the same page. We can go ahead and place the order. So you can use this one with your colleagues, with anyone that you work with about any topic, okay? You could also say, I want us all to be on the same page, or let's try to get everyone on the same page. Let's try to get everyone to agree on this topic. 11 is to zero in on something. Now, if you zero in on something, this means to put all of your focus on one specific thing. So for example, our product returns have doubled in the last month. We need to zero in on the root of this problem. Our product returns have doubled in the last month. We need to zero in on the root of this problem. Now, this example means that the number of items that our customers are returning has doubled. So there's obviously a problem if our customers are returning twice as many products as they were last month, right? So we need to zero in on or focus on the problem. Why are our customers returning so many products? Zero in on something, focus on one specific thing. Number 12 is down the line, down the line. Now, down the line just means sometime later or sometime in the future. So for example, a positive customer experience will lead to repeat business down the line. So if our customers have a good experience now, they will come back down the line or later on or at some point in the future. 13 is to raise the bar, to raise the bar. Now, to raise the bar means to increase standards or increase expectations. So for example, Apple raised the bar with the iPhone. Once Apple came out with the iPhone, all other mobile phone companies had to compete. That was the new standard for cell phones, right? So Apple raised the bar with the iPhone, to raise the bar, to increase standards or expectations. 14 is to hit the nail on the head, to hit the nail on the head. So to hit the nail on the head means that you are exactly right when you say something. For example, I think Joe hit the nail on the head. The problem here is our pricing is not competitive. So I think Joe is exactly right in saying that our pricing is not competitive. 15 is behind the scenes. Now, behind the scenes refers to work that must be done in order to make something happen or to make something successful, but people don't actually see this work. It is done behind the scenes. So if you imagine a live play or a live concert, if you are in the audience, of course you only see the performers, the actors, or the singers, but there's a lot of work that goes on behind the scenes in order to make that happen, all right? So for example, thank you all so much for your hard work behind the scenes. This event would not have been possible without you. So again, behind the scenes refers to the work that needs to be done to make something a success, but people don't actually see that work. They just see the end result. Number 16 is back to square one. Back to square one. Now, back to square one means to start something over from scratch, from zero, from the beginning. So for example, the client was unhappy with the proposal, so it's back to square one. So we created this proposal for the client did not like it, and now we have to start again. Back to square one. Number 17 is to think outside the box, to think outside the box. So to think outside the box means to think in an innovative, creative, unique way that you don't normally think. So for example, we are looking to hire people who think outside the box. So this means we want to hire people who think in a unique way, in a creative or innovative way. Okay, one more example. This approach is not working anymore. We really need to think outside the box, okay? So again, you can use this when you're talking to colleagues, when you're talking to your team, or to describe the type of person that you want to hire. Number 18 is to touch base, to touch base. Now, to touch base just means to get in contact with someone. So if you call someone, if you send an email, if you drop by someone's office, you are touching base or getting in contact with them. This one is super easy to use. For example, I will touch base with you later this week to discuss the details. I'll touch base with you later this week to discuss the details. So touch base, get in contact. Number 19 is at the end of the day, at the end of the day. So at the end of the day is a really nice introductory phrase that means ultimately or finally. So for example, at the end of the day, our goal is to increase profit. At the end of the day, our goal is to decrease our expenses. At the end of the day, our goal is to keep our customers happy. Okay, so ultimately, finally, at the end of the day. And number 20 is to call it a day, to call it a day. So if you call it a day, it means you decide to stop working, usually that for that particular day. So for example, we've made a lot of progress today. Let's call it a day. We've made a lot of progress today. We've worked hard. We've done well. Let's call it a day. Let's stop working for today. Let's go home, basically. One more example. You have learned 20 idioms today. I think we can call it a day. So there you have it, 20 advanced business English idioms that you can use at work with your colleagues, your clients, and your customers. Now, if you want to learn even more business English idioms, phrasal verbs, and vocabulary, make sure you check out my Essential English for Business course. It is a super practical course that's really going to help you take your business English skills to the next level. So the link is in the description down below. And as always, thank you so much for watching and for learning with me, and I will see you very soon in the next lesson.